London.
We are now jumping Cyprus.
It's
been to final.
It's been great, it's been great. We just finished sound checking and
this is Cyprus, and one of the longest shows to select the audition.
From a year ago, go on, like so many shows and auditions.
How did I
feel about it?
It was great, it was great. It was really tiring. Exhausting actually, you know, all these shows and all this rehearsing and comments from judges and clothing and everything has to be every time perfect. And it was like 60 acts, then down to 20, then 10, then 6, and then 1.
And then you got it.
Yeah, so it was a really long procedure, and we actually won. Yeah.
And how did you do to keep your calm and your focus?
I'm a really calm person. I don't really get stressed out really. But yeah, I just believed in my song and I just hoped for the best. That's how I did it.
And why don't you tell us a little bit about the song itself? Writing process, how it all came about.
Okay, the song's called One Thing You Should Have Done. And it's written by Michael Harris, lyrics and music. And it's a really simple song, a love song, ballad. Its meaning is that you have to be truthful in every situation, especially relationships. And look back at me, that's the main thing. But I think everybody can absorb it and understand it any way they feel like they want it.
How did you land on your lap?
It's because ridiculous. Told me that there is this guy, Karayiannis, who I knew from Stronger Than Me. And he told me that he wants to be in Eurovision from Cyprus, and he's looking for a singer.
You're waiting
to like to find him a song. Wow, yeah, let's definitely do that. And so I sent him a song on a private YouTube link. And he called me up and says, hey, I want you to come to London so we can meet each other and maybe work together. And so I came here. We met each other, got to chat, and
you know,
our music, our taste, and each other. So he got to know me better, and sent me off to all the tourist attractions in London until he writes the song. And called me back, and said, come to my studio, I want to play you the song.
So I go there, it was just a chorus at the time.
And he sings it himself. He's a terrible singer. He sings it, and I go, wow, you know, this is something, special. I can sing that. So he writes the entire song throughout the time that I'm in London. We sign up for the Cyprus Eurovision. That's how it happens.
And that's what happened. And that's how here you are. You said you every minute. Yeah, you did it. You've been surrounded by a lot of Eurovision stuff, which the respect you are from Eurovision, judges were from Eurovision, you're writer, doing everything that. So, is this all that you expected it to be so far?
I don't think anyone expects it to be so special and so amazing, you know? It's the greatest experience of my life so far. And, no, I wasn't expecting it to be so great, you know?
But how are you used to it in terms of your career? Okay, now you're going to be exposed, you're going to have a whole country, and, you know, a lot of Greece as well, you know, like watching closely. What are the next steps? What are you planning on doing?
I'm moving to London in September, and I'm working on an album with Mike, so we're writing our own music. And while I'm doing that, I'm also studying here music in a university, so yeah, that's how it's going to go for me.
And what type of album? What's the type of music genre?
We're not sure yet, but music I listen to is, I actually listen to everything, anything that sounds good to my ear. And but mostly jazz, pop, blues, and that sort of thing.
Brilliant. And just to let you go, do you have one last message for the CSEX?
Okay, just a second. Sorry about that. I just want to say, if you like our song, please feel free